Over the years, French rugby has maintained its reputation for flair and improvisation, but such artistry would be impossible without a solid and advancing platform supplied by the forwards. And this season, despite their frailties elsewhere on the field, the French scrummage has remained a powerfully effective weapon. This, in large part, down to state-of-the-art scrum machinery.
It's a physically demanding machine, so we don't use it too often, just half an hour a week and only a couple of impacts. It's not something you can use every day because it's pretty tough physically.
We have sensors on each player's head, which take approximately 1,000 measurements per second. This tells us very precisely the angles of force and the reaction speed of the players in a scrum situation.
Using the same technology employed in the development of flight simulators, this is the world's most versatile scrum machine. It accurately replicates twisting and collapsing scrums, simultaneously taking into account player safety and the pace of the modern game.
At the beginning, it was used to understand accidents in the scrum. We've now also discovered why scrums collapse. In measuring the force of the players, we notice that the players knock each other out of position with their shoulders, and so the scrum collapses. We didn't know that before.
In international rugby nowadays, we spend a lot of time having to reset the scrum. Rugby is becoming more and more spectacular, so the less time we can waste on scrums, the more you get out of the game. During a tournament, we've seen the amount of time wasted on scrums, so we are trying to avoid that by predicting the opposition's approach to the scrum and trying to find a solution to that before the game.
The machine has additional features and can be programmed to simulate the characteristics of opposition packs.
We try to reproduce to some extent what the opposition do. Do they cause a lot of impact or not? Do they tend to be unstable? Do they control their position on top? Do they jostle against the props? And so we try to reproduce what the players do, to put our players in a real situation, almost in a match situation.
I like it. It lets you put targeted pressure on the props and allows you to work on blocking and creating pressure. It lets you put pressure on the left or the right of the scrum. It's really useful not just for the props, but for the second and back rows as well. It allows you to all work together.
I think above all, we've been able to optimize our training. So we've saved time in training sessions without the problems of opposition. The machine always does what you want every time, and so we have sessions that are very precise, quite short, and more effective.
And the French Federation are making the most of their valuable asset, using it to aid in the development of players both young and old.
In five sessions, players can be transformed from virtual novices to a very high level. With the under-20s, we have a pack of French players that produces a force of 30% higher than the average pack.
It's a contemporary tool which allows us to work on this complex exercise and allows established players like myself to be able to train under match conditions, to work on the pushing within the scrum and its instability. What's most interesting is that young players can prove their worth against the machine, gain experience and play in the context of a match. It definitely helps speed up their development as players.
Ça permet leur éclosion beaucoup plus précoce.